down. And we've got a middleweight fight coming up next. Jaime, let's talk about the two pugilists.
Pues sabemos que al final se encuentran estos dos que estaban pendientes aquí en el Orleans Casino. Es la tercera vez que Simón Rubalcaba se va a enfrentar aquí a alguien en este ring. Y pues sabemos que su rival, Rodrigo Aguiar, será la sexta ocasión que va a tener aquí su participación en el programa de Crowning Boxing aquí en el San Luca. Y gracias a nuestros patrocinadores, Metro PCC y Budweiser, que hacen posible este evento, y por supuesto también el Orleans Casino.
And Jaime does a great job. You can see he's a seasoned pro. He always gets Frank and Crown Boxing, Frank Luca, the guy who brought us all here. He's got Budweiser, Metro PCS, and the Orleans.
Didn't miss anybody.
You know, that's a pro, because it is the it's the business of boxing along with the sport.
That's right.
But Rubalcaba, he's been here before. He's been under the lights in the open. We talked a little bit about that advantage. Because this is a very intimate, this is a great fight atmosphere, but probably a little taking you something to get used to, Chuck.
Oh, definitely, definitely. The fights here remind me of when I first came to Vegas in 1980. We had fights every week at the Silver Slipper, and it's the same atmosphere. It's packed. Every event here is packed. It's a very enthusiastic crowd. And it makes for it really helps the fighters.
Well, we've got a good one coming up. Now we'll go up to ring announcer Jake Gutierrez with the call.
And now we continue here at the Orleans, ladies and gentlemen. This next bout is scheduled for four rounds in the middleweight division. Our three judges scoring will be Al Lefkowitz, Dave Moretti, and Jerry Roth. Our referee in charge is Joe Cortez. Introducing first, he'll be fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the solid red trunks, and he weighed in at 164 pounds. His professional record stands at 4 victories with 9 defeats and 2 draws. From South Lake Tahoe, California, introducing El Nino, Simon Rubalcaba. And his opponent fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the black trunks trimmed in silver, and he weighed in at 165 pounds. His professional record stands at 4 victories with 3 defeats. Coming to us from Norwalk, California, introducing Rodrigo, the Iceman Aguiar.
Joe Cortez in the middle. And Chuck, as a judge, you know the importance of a referee. There aren't too many better.
Joe is one of the top probably 2 or 3 in the world. He's excellent, excellent referee, and he's very, very concerned about the safety of the fighters.
Well, you know, and what is fantastic for a guy like Frank Luca who puts fights on in Vegas, you get the benefit of having the best officials, the best judges. You can't ask for anything more. Round one underway.
Vemos que ambos están estudiando bastante, y pues vemos que Rodrigo siempre ha sido una persona que viene agresivo, así es que como lo dije anteriormente, él no le importa recibir con tal de dar un golpe bueno para poner a su rival en malas condiciones. Y vemos que Rubalcaba pues le está agarrando demasiado respeto y está boxeando de una manera a la distancia, quitándose fuera del alcance de Rodrigo, que trata de cazarlo como a la liebre, ¿verdad?
Now you are doing a good job forcing Rubalcaba into his corners. He's doing a good job of ring generalship right now.
Yes, he is, and Rubalcaba looks like he's just, I don't think he's warmed up yet. he's very, very defensive. Actually, he's not even showing much defense. He's just backing up a lot.
Yeah, he's basically covered about a quarter mile right now, all of it in reverse.
He looks a lot different than his last fight here.
Tiene 4 peleas y 9 derrotas, 4 peleas ganadas de Rubalcaba y 9 derrotas con 2 empates, o sea, tiene 55 asaltos de experiencia. Y pues a Rodrigo Aguiar tiene 4 victorias y 3 empates. Rodrigo Aguiar tiene 29 años y pues a Rubalcaba tiene 30, así es que están más o menos parejos en esa categoría. Y pues vemos ahí que Aguiar se ve más seguro, nomás que falta que conecte. Está conectando buenos golpes ahora al cuerpo y ahora a la cara. Y vemos que como que se tambalea Rubalcaba, quién sabe qué le pasa. No entró listo, como dice aquí el señor Chuck Ciampa, que no entró listo para este combate. Lo hemos visto más activo, lo hemos visto de una manera más bien, y ahora como que le falta ese toque.
Aguilar very much stand up, getting in there and taking care of business, Chuck.
Yes, first 2 minutes, Aguilar is doing a great job. He's very, very effective, being the aggressor, and it's pretty much a one-sided round at this point.
Yeah, and Rubikovlet, not a lot of snap into his punches. He's just kind of throwing them out there. Doesn't have a lot of power in him.
Very flat, very flat. As I said, he doesn't seem to be, doesn't seem to have warmed up. And his timing is off.
Just landed a soft right there, nothing on it. It was a great opportunity to get in. And Aguilar's hands were down and didn't have anything on that punch.
Y lo interesante es que Rubalcaba, cuando estaban ellos programados para pelear en mayo, y Aguilar por problemas personales, pues se canceló la pelea. Y Rubalcaba dijo que hasta lloró porque estaba preparado de una manera que nunca se había sentido. Y pues ahora era modo de demostrar que pues es buen gallo, que en cualquier terreno canta. Y al menos en este round no lo vimos tan activo, ya cansado, ya cortado de un ojo. Y pues no nos extrañe que en el siguiente asalto, pues a Aguilar acabe por knockout.
That'll do it for action in round number two. Round number two. The ring car girl came up. Chuck, she threw me off. She had second round on there, and my concentration
focused,
went.
Got to stay focused.
Yeah, focus is a problem here. Action in round number two coming up. Plus, we'll get the punch stat numbers from round number two. One, and Chuck, the expert, will give us his thoughts. We'll be right back. Yeah, let me do that again. Okay. Okay, coming back in three. Oh, real quick. Coming back in three, two. Chuck, your thoughts on round number one.
Oh, easy round for Aguilar. He controlled it, controlled the full 3 minutes. He was aggressive, showing ring generalship, and his punches were very, very effective.
And it almost seems like Rubikova has a sparring partner mentality. He's just kind of being passive out there. Jaime, what do you think?
Pues vemos que Aguilar está dominando y ya vemos tambalearse a Rubalcaba y pues creemos que se va a caer o no trae ganas de pelear, simplemente, como se dice, vino nomás por el cheque porque no le estamos viendo muchas ganas de pelear, sus golpes no son con contundencia, se ve fuera de condición y pues Aguilar pues está listo para ponerlo fuera de combate. Aguilar sabemos que es un hombre de familia, casado con 4 hijos y trabaja de mayordomo en la construcción, o sea, manda, y aquí está comandando el combate que no creemos que pase este asalto.
And a little cut opened up over Rubikov's right eye, and that's going to be a problem coming in, and referee's got to be very, very cognizant of that, Chuck.
And it depends on where the cut is. It could be a lot of bleeding, as long as it doesn't impair the vision. He'll be looking at that cut to see where it's at, and, you know, very important to have. That's why I was impressed in the first fight, to have a good cut man, even at this stage in their careers. But Rubikova is he just has no defense at all right now. As I said, he's very flat.
Yeah, a little surprising. We've seen him in the past. He's come out with some snap, but right now Aguilar is having his way with him. And you can see Rubikova just can't even get a right going.
Well, he got wobbled in the first minute. I don't think he's fully recovered. Aguilar really hasn't taken advantage of that.
A little bit surprising. Aguilar a little flat on his feet now.
Yeah.
No, vemos que ya está terminado Rubalcaba. De plano no vino a pelear este hombre porque está recibiendo de todo. Y se me hace hasta extraño que no haya caído, pero ahí está dando 5 o 6 golpes hasta más en la cara. Pero Rubalcaba trata de darse valor y sacándolo del alma porque ya está siendo demasiado golpeado. Y el referee está muy atento para ver si de plano pues para el combate porque pues no está haciendo mucho daño Rubalcaba con sus golpes. Y fíjense que a Rodrigo está programado para pelear en Fallon, Nevada, el 29 del mes. Así es que esta pelea parece que va a tenerla fácil. Ahora toma un descanso para seguir golpeando. Y pues Rubalcaba aprovecha y trata de meter sus golpes, pero no le demos mucha fuerza a sus golpes. Creemos que ya está a punto de caer a la lona.
And Chuck, it almost seemed like Rubalcaba was getting ready to go down, and yet he got his feet again.
Well, actually, this is the type of a round that the judge is probably looking almost as a 10-8. Aguilar has dominated it so much, just short of a knockdown. He's been wobbled. If I were scoring this round, this would be a 10-8 even without a knockdown for Akhmedov. Just thoroughly dominated it.
And Rubalcaba has to be very happy to be still in this fight through round number two.
Para mí lo que pasó es que no vino preparado mental ni físicamente para esta pelea Rubalcaba, porque ya vimos que sí trae corazón. Si fuera otro en su lugar, pues ya había tocado las gambas, pero está ahí recibiendo todo y tratando de igualar la balanza que se le va del lado, pero entonces vemos que no trae condición.
That'll do it for action in round number two. Third round coming up next. Hey, Jaime, when you're doing the description, we've got replays coming up, so talk to the replay. Okay.